Iowa looks so beautiful from its rivers. I mean, it's a real huge contrast from being on the interstate and seeing cornfields and bean fields to getting in a kayak or a canoe and seeing, you know, the green belts and all the wildlife that accompanies it.
John Wenk is one member of a group of Central Iowans advocating recreation on Iowa's rivers and the creation of what are called water trails.
Water trail is basically a stretch of river that has a beginning point and an end point, and it has places that you can exit and get on the river at different sections. A water trail like they're creating here in Iowa actually will have kiosks that talk about, that display the types of wildlife you might be able to see on that stretch, might give some cultural or historical information about the particular stretch of river. A water trail will also have warning signage if there's a low head dam on that section of river, and a portage trail around the dam.
There are many popular local places to go to enjoy canoeing and kayaking.
In central Iowa, I would say the Des Moines River and the Raccoon River are real popular stretches. Both of them, of course, converge in Des Moines. The Boone River is really a beautiful stretch.
Some paddlers even take to the water during Iowa's cold winter months.
You pretty much have the river to yourself. There isn't the normal types of recreation that are happening, and there's a lot of wildlife in the wintertime, especially bird watching. That's when all the eagles come in the winter. You can see lots of eagles on the river, osprey, a lot of your raptor species of birds.
John recommends bringing the proper equipment along on the water.
You definitely have to have a PFD, which is a personal flotation device, aka life preserver or life jacket. You definitely, it's required by the state to actually have one on board, but we recommend that you actually be wearing it. You also want to dress for the weather. You want to dress for the temperature of the water. So sometimes folks in the spring and the fall can find themselves in a bad situation because the air might be warm, but the water is still pretty cold. So if you plan on doing any fall or spring paddling, you need to have proper warm weather clothing.
John also recommends staying away from downed trees, which can trap paddlers in strong currents, and very dangerous low-head dams.
Low-head dams are probably the biggest hazard that Iowa has. Not all of our dams, in fact, most of them are not well marked with portage trails, and they're hard to see from upstream.
Nate Hogeveen's Paddling Iowa book is a great guide to river trails around the state if you're interested in taking up canoeing or kayaking. John Wenk recommends benefiting from the experience of veteran paddlers.
The best way to learn this type of sport is to get involved with a group like Central Iowa Paddlers or the Iowa Whitewater Coalition.
For Happy Trails, I'm meteorologist Jason Parkin for KCCI, Iowa's News Leader.